If you could snap your fingers and go anywhere, anywhere at all, where would you go? Would you go to the bottom of the sea, where none of your problems could find you? Or would you go back to that first snowfall from when you were a kid? The one that doesn't quite feel the same now that you're all grown up? Would you face your worst fear? Or maybe you'd go to that party you were never invited to. Oh my god, no, not that. Would you go to the future? Or would you go
back to before you were born, when everybody talked like this for some reason?
Maybe you go here. Or here. Or here. Or maybe here. Or here. Maybe you'd go here. Or would you rather be standing in the Van Angola room right now, surrounded by thousands of people who, for once, like all the same shit you do? Well, all right then. Let's go there.
Wish I was a stone, so I couldn't feel. You'd yell in my face, it'd be no big deal. But I miss the way we make up and smile. Don't wanna be stone, I changed my mind. I wish I had eyes in the back of my head, then I could see the places I've been. But then I would know that you're talking shit. I don't wanna know what my friends think. Wish I were my dog out on the lawn. I'd be so glad when I hear you come home. But if I were my dog, I wouldn't live long. I'm sure gonna miss her when she's gone. I wish I could act in a show on TV, 'cause then I could practice not being me. I'll practice my cry, put it into my reel, but you won't believe me when I cry for real. I wish that my brain would trip inside. I'd nail every joke, I'd win every fight, but I get too deep with that kind of mind. I don't wanna know the point of life. In some other life, I would be rich. I drive out in style, I cover the bill, but couldn't complain about anything small. Nobody feel bad for me at all. If I was cocaine or a bottle of Jack, I'd get invited to every frat. But when you get old, when you're sad, wish I was a son, your favorite one. You follow the dance to be at your ground. I will be there when your baby is born. For 2 or 3 minutes and I'm gone. I wish I was big, I'd stay as my house. I'd sleep on the trees, I'd skip every crowd. But I would be fit on my therapist's couch. God, I could really use it now.
Feel young.
time that I saw your face was recess in second grade, and it made me feel young. Okay! Won't you help me sober up? Walk it out to maybe now. And I wanna feel something again. Won't you help me sober up? All the big kids, they got drunk. And I wanna feel something again. Won't you help me feel something again?
How we doing? Are we okay? Wow. This is very cool. Where did you come from? What is this? What is this? Ladies and gentlemen, this is the ninth show of AJR's first ever headlining arena tour. Every night I always plan to say something, get up here and, you know, have something cool planned, and I swear to God, the lights always turn on and I always forget what I'm gonna say because this just blows my mind. I have no idea how this happened. Thank you so much for coming. Since I don't know what to say, I'm just gonna go ahead and intro the band. We're a band called AJR Grand Rapids, yes. Yep. We got Adam over there. My name is Jack. And we got Ryan in the glasses. Hello. Before we move forward, let me just address that for a sec. What just happened? I feel like if you've seen us live before, you know that I make it pretty apparent how angry it makes me that that Ryan gets the most applause out of the three of us. Like that. It sounds a lot like that. Yeah. Like that. And I've been doing some thinking, and I'm realizing that it's not a good color on me. It's not a good look. So I've decided that I'm gonna drop that. I'm gonna start being nicer to you. A little less bullying going on. Wow. Like, for instance, I'm definitely not gonna bring up the body odor issue. I'm not gonna bring it up. No, I'm not gonna. I'm not gonna say it. I'm definitely not gonna bring up the fact that you wore braces for longer than the average kid. I'm not gonna say it. Not gonna say it. No, and I'm definitely not gonna mention the fact that your first kiss was in 12th grade. You tell everyone it was in 9th grade. I'm not gonna say it. I'm gonna be better.
Wow.
Yeah.
You've really grown, Jack.
Thank you, I've been working.
Thank you.
I've been working. Ladies and gentlemen, like I said, I don't know what to say. We love each and every one of you so much. This is our favorite thing to do. Thank you so much for being here, Grand Rapids. And once again, welcome to the Maybe Man Tour. It's actually a mashup that we found on YouTube. A fan made this kind of combination of two of our songs. We listened to it and it sounded weirdly good.
And so what we're gonna do now is we're gonna play a cover of a fan doing a cover of our music. Please don't sue us.
It's not too much, you tell me to win, to win today, to win today. Yeah. I got the one telling me, but maybe Japan. Pretty people yelling me to follow the dance. So I do what you tell me to win, to win today. But I can do this shit again. Put your hands up, cause I won't. Raise the glass up, cause I won't. Get your ass up, cause I won't. I must have missed the height, but maybe that's the way I feel. Put your hands up. I don't got nobody like I see in the press. So I got to the precipice, a press in my chest. And now I look impressive with a couple of things, just like my friends. So I'll come back and take a breath. You come tonight, you're bored to death. So I'll come back and take a breath. You come tonight, but I digress. Put your hands up, you sound low. Raise the glass up, you sound low. Get your ass up, you sound low. I must have missed the hype, but maybe that's the way I feel. Put your hands up, you sound low. I'm not here cause you say so. Get your ass up, you sound low. I must have missed the hype, but maybe that's the way I feel. That's the way I feel.
Thank you.
So, we didn't quite know where to put this song in the set. We talked for a while about it, and I don't want to bring down the mood too much, but we realized we had to play it at some point. And it would help if you just sang along like this.
God is really real when you really, really need him. God just appears when you suddenly believe it. Here and out and clear, just as long as it's convenient. Life's fucking long till it stops. And God's fucking fake till he's not. My dad can't get out of bed. There's something in his lungs, I think that's what the doctor said. I gotta leave for Paris now, my bank goes on at 10. And my dad can't get out of bed. The earth is spinning like it always did. The New York Times is publishing some new important thing. And each day when the world wakes up, our lawns will still be wet. And my dad can't get out of bed.
Let's hear it.
God is really real when you really, really need him. Karma just appears when you suddenly believe me. Hear it loud and clear. Stops and God's fucking fake till he's not. Now it's late, I really gotta go. And we can't face our feelings, so we're making lots of jokes. And we won't cry about it, no, we'll be manly men. I love you, sounds all corny, so I wrote this song instead. I'll sing it for you, Dad, when you get out of bed. I'll sing for you when you're out of bed.
Skip to the good part.
good.
What the hell am I gonna do with mine?
At first, this next one was our most Broadway-sounding song. After some work, it kind of became our darkest song, and when it was finished, it ended up being our weirdest song. But after all that, for some reason, it became our biggest song.
I get up, I get down, and I'm jumping around. In the office of work, it's so comfortable now. Been a hell of a ride, but I'm thinking it's time to grow. So I got an apartment across from the bar. Cookie wine in my fridge, still I'm not feeling wrong. Been a hell of a ride, but I'm thinking it's time to go.
So,
here we go.
Taxes are due, do my best, we'll begin with the one or two. Been a hell of a ride, but I'm thinking it's time to grow.
Metronome.
Man, I'm up to something. Woody-da-dee-do, thank you all for coming. I hope you like the show, cause it's on a budget. So woody-da-dee-do, man, come on, here we go.
an effort.
Grand Rapids, are we still okay? All right, I'm gonna do something right now. This is something I like to do during every single show. And the reason I do it, you can see on the screen, we have these things in our ears. They're called in-ear monitors, and they help us hear the music. But at the same time, they're very isolating from you guys, which is not a good feeling. So just for like a minute or two, I'm just gonna like point out people in the crowd that I've seen thus far into the show that have sort of caught my attention.
Oh yeah, I like this.
Yeah, there's a lot of you tonight. There's some really interesting ones too. Wow, some signs I hadn't seen. That one looks promising. I'll return to that one. I want to start with, I mean, the shoulders always works, but unfortunately I'm going to the guy right in front of you, okay? No, right, yes, you. I know, you're confused, and you should be, because you don't really know what you did, but I'll tell you what you did. It was very interesting. Here we go, it's Sober Up. I haven't seen this before, it's very interesting. It's Sober Up, I was singing the song, he knew every lyric, clear that he knows the music, and we got up to the part that goes, ba ba da da da. How's it going again? So I go, bop, he's got his hands up, he goes, da 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 da, how's it go again? And he goes like this. And then he goes like, there's no drop. And he gets a little upset. And then we come around to the second chorus. And it happens again. I go, bop, bop, and he's like, it's Shirley this time. Bop, how's it go again? And he gets upset. And it's so interesting because the song's been out for like 1,000 years. And you know every lyric to it too. Why all of a sudden would we put a drop in there and you get really mad at us? You want a drop. Where's the banjo solo in Ride and Solo by Jason Derulo? It's not coming. It's not there. It's never been there. We'll have our own private concert after and I'll do a 3-hour DJ set for you. Yeah? If that's what you need. I love it. For you. Everything's for you.
Yeah. I saw something kind of interesting.
You saw someone.
It's kind of sort of along the same lines. So these three gentlemen in green. Yeah, don't look to either side. I'm pointing right at you.
Oh boy.
Yeah, right there.
Yeah.
So I guess we didn't really know this was going to happen, but in I Won't, we go, put your hands up because I won't. And kind of all the hands shoot up. Not yours. You're listening intently to the lyrics, and we're saying, put your hands up, because I won't. And I'm seeing you in the first chorus kind of look around. I'm listening to the lyrics. Hoping that other people will join. Next chorus comes around. I'm still listening to the lyrics. So I want to thank you for that.
Did people end up joining, or?
It was just him.
No. It was just him. That's all right. Plenty of shows to go, my friend. This one's, I don't even know what to do with this sign here. This is, so we have a sign right here that says, please embarrass my girlfriend. Although, I'm looking at her and she's got the phone out. She's got super extroverted right away. I'm feeling like there's little I could do to embarrass you. Do you want to come? Oh, it's your birthday today. It's your connected birthday. It's so funny, I try to avoid the happy birthday song, but the sign was just so enticing, I feel like we have to do it. Right, you know what, who else has a birthday today so we can get them all done at once so people don't complain? Hold on, we're gonna start with you, hold on. We're gonna do names. We'll do 100. How many? Wait, what's your name? Tanner and Michaela. Oh boy, let's get a lot of syllables here. All right, hold on, let's do you. What's your name? DJ, right? Okay. DJ, Tanner, Michaela, who else do we got? 15th birthday over here. Who else do we got? Who, what's your name? Cooper. Forgot them all already. All right. I think we can, four is enough. Ready? Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Oh my God. Happy birthday, dear Tanner. Michaela. DJ Cooper, oh yeah! Happy birthday to you! Yeah! Are you sufficiently embarrassed? Oh my God. You are tough, you are tough. Ladies and gentlemen, just for the last thing, I have to say, this is really important, because you've been so patient, sir. You've been so patient. What was that?
We throwing things now? Is it a little duck? Oh, that's kind of sweet, honestly. That's kind of a sweet one. That was you. We'll play catch for a while. There we go. No, yes, sir, you've been very patient. We're gonna do this right now. Ladies and gentlemen, the thing that we're about to do, we do a lot of nights on stage. The reason we keep doing it over and over is because what we try to do with the bit has not been sort of accomplished yet. I'll tell you what I mean.
That's right.
6 years ago, Ryan lost his favorite hat on a plane. It's a true story, I promise. And from then on, he's been searching for a new hat for literally 6 years.
That's true.
You haven't found the right one, and we like to do this during these shows because you guys come with such great hats. And I just got a feeling about this one tonight, and I think you do too. Why don't we pass that one up right now? Nice. Yes. Yes. Oh, God, it's shedding and everything. It's perfect. Oh.
It's wet.
Oh, it's soaking. Just put it on. Just throw that on. It's screaming, Ryan. Oh, God, so many similarities already. Oh, it's a mask as well. Good. It doesn't smell too good in there. All right, that's all right. All right. He's going to, yeah, move to the center. He's going to turn around, and we'll do, like, an applause meter, okay? With length and volume, and we'll see if this is really, really the one for him, because I got a good feeling about this one. A little bit of this. Okay, well, okay, we'll do that after. All right, 3, 2, 1, show up!
This smells like it was once a real chicken, but the applause was so loud that I think I'll keep it on for a couple minutes.
Jesus, look how that mic goes right down the beak. That is not something that should be blown up to that size. Oh boy. okay, good. I think he was wearing it as like a hat before, like this. I think you can wear it like that too. Are we good?
It still stinks.
Oh God, it's just as sticky, huh? All right, that's all right. Ladies and gentlemen of Grand Rapids, before we continue the show, I just want to say something a little more serious. We've been playing, when's the first time we played Grand Rapids?
About 5 years ago.
5 years we were playing Grand Rapids, yes. And what venue was that?
The first venue was the Delta Plex.
Yeah. Some of you were there.
And then, yeah. Then we came back, and because we didn't get any bigger, we played the Delta Plex again.
Couldn't escape the Delta Plex.
Yeah.
And, both of those times, I believe each of those shows had around
3,000
people or so, which blew our mind at the time. And just the reason that we're telling you that is because tonight, ladies and gentlemen, there are 10,000 people here tonight. And I have no words for it. Seriously, it's crazy to us. And the reason I'm saying all this is to tell you that we've been doing this a long time. And we've had a lot of friends in the industry, artist friends, who have kind of stopped and quit over the years for whatever reason. The fans sort of didn't keep up, or they weren't feeling it anymore. And I'm saying all this just to tell you guys how unbelievably rare this is. This does not happen. It just doesn't in this industry. So I just have to thank you so much for coming tonight, letting us do this. Thank you for this. Like I said, Grand Rapids, we love you. You know it. They get it. Let's keep this show going right now.
Thank you.
said I would start working now, but I'm fucking hungry and screw you for trying. I wanna be big like my friends, so why am I so tiny and why am I so mad? It's inertia. Yes, this is just what I am. I'm stuck in this life and I'm stuck in these bed. Thank you. I've been so good, I've been helpful and friendly. I've been so good, why am I feeling empty? I've been so good, I've been so good this year. And I've been so good, but it's still getting harder. I've been so good, where the hell is the karma? I've been so good, I've been so good this year.
Three songs right now. I'm gonna play a trilogy of songs. This is one song about thinking I was in love. Another song about realizing I wasn't in love at all. And then a third song about actually falling in love.
I'm still
not chosen than unique. Honestly, you were and you chose me. Maybe I fucked up everything. Is this how it feels to be blue? You said you'd love me no matter what. You said you loved me, is that what I loved? All of these choices messed me up, and everyone's mean except you. I think I probably wasn't in love with you. I think I probably loved the idea of you. And though I may be missing the feeling of you, I think I probably wasn't in love with you. I said it cause I no longer wanna hurt. I said it back to you cause you said it first. And though I may be wishing it wasn't true, I think I probably wasn't in love. I wasn't in love with you. Got it out of my system, didn't I? Did my 2 years on Tinder, didn't I? Well, I wanted to be wanted. Suddenly I'm wanting more. So we got a bit tangled, didn't we? It's the best thing that's happened to me. Got exactly what I wanted. What if I don't want this? Am I missing something? But half the time I can't love right. Sex and we both get quiet. Boy, I must be one fucked up guy. Oh my God, what a crazy mind. It'll be fine, quick, let's get married. Man, I wish we were really fine. The rest of our life wouldn't sound so scary. Oh, I'm spiraling now. Let's get attention from you. Though we shrug it off as nothing, life is pretty long. It could turn into something. But half the time I can't love right, and I'm half yours and you're all mine. Boy, I must be one fucked up guy. Let's do it today. to like it.
We're up here now. We're here now. Hello. Ladies and gentlemen, we have always wanted to play a song from the crowd. And we've never been able to on any of the tours that we've been on until now. They told us it was okay and we just leaped at that opportunity. So we're gonna do just that. We're gonna play a song in the audience for you right now, and it's a sing-along. Let's do it together.
My grandpa fought in World War II. He was such a normal dude. I can't even finish school, cause my mom had left too soon. Was a fireman who fought fire so violently. I pick up on my therapist for playing him my violin.
Oh my God,
that's so insane.
Oh my God,
that's a shame. Thanks to him, my shit don't feel so great. But I can't help myself feeling bad. I kinda feel like two things can be said. But hey, the world's smallest violin really needs an audience. So I'll blow up into smithereens and steal my tiny symphony. I'll up and down the city, see if I'm trying to blow my mind at ease. I'm finishing this melody, this feels like a necessity. So this can be the death of me, or maybe this can better me. The running with the tendencies and take a shot at Hennessy. And I'm about to leave, but you can play the remedy. So let me play my violin for you.
I did it! Thank you so much, Ann Rapids. Thank you. Letting us live our dream out here. How you guys doing? Yeah? Where are you from? Where are you from? Hastings? Oh boy. There's an inside joke here that I don't know about. I should have planned something past where are you from. I don't have any jokes for Hastings. I got nothing. But thanks for coming to the show. Appreciate it. Ladies and gentlemen, I think this is so fun that we have to play another one. I think we should play another one from up here. And it's also a sing-along. Let's do it.
Steve's going around here. Shots stuck in a cell. Tom sleeps on his best friend's lawn like every other afternoon. Steve's going to London. Dad beating the bull. Tom put my shoes on. Not something I neglect, cause you were late a bit. But no one's gonna care about a shoe song. I try hard to write a cool song, but I gotta make it matter, so maybe I'll put the news on. Could I relate to shoes to 2022? Or maybe an election down in Tucson. I try to go with something cool long. So I'm listening to Kevin can play in that swimming pool song. Oh, why did I do that? Cause now I hate my track. Right away, I'll never write a cool song. But who really needs a cool song? There's so many, 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 and no one. So stop writing a song, about writing a song. You're losing your attention, buddy, move on.
He's going to London.
What the hell?
Sean's stuck in a zoo.
I gotta get back to stage.
Sean sleeps on his best friend's lawn. Like every
hour after. Just keep playing till I get there. Keep playing that, I'm on my way.
Way back to the stage. I'm going to take this moment to introduce incredibly talented musicians we have up here tonight. Up first, she is new to touring with us. She plays violin and saxophone. My pleasure to introduce Miss Ginny Luke.
Used to keep it cool, used to be a fool, I never you gonna do? I couldn't refresh and forget your sticky poo. She said keep it light, stay out of the fight. No one's gonna listen to me. If I write a song, preaching what is wrong, will they let me sing on TV? Should I keep it light?
The show. If any of you guys know this, we write and produce and record all of our music in our living room. And when we produce, when we produce, we like to experiment a lot. Produce with a lot of layers, experiment, try and find weird sounds you don't normally hear in music. So if it's all right with you guys, I'm gonna show you how we produce one of our songs, okay? Now this one is special, because it took us 20 years to create. Okay, we were working last year, and we started with a kick drum. Could you slow that kick drum down? More. Oh, that's better. Okay, then we went about looking for a hi-hat. Something like this. What about if you sped that hi-hat up? More. More. Yeah. Okay, cool. So far we had our kick, we had our hi-hat. And after 5 minutes of producing, we were exhausted. So we decided to go to lunch. We were at lunch, and I remember we ordered our food, and the waiter came back and he put down our food. He put down the plate in a really interesting way. Like this. Sounded cool. So we had the waiter do it again. And we recorded it this time. Like this. Cool. And then we went about flamming. So flamming is when you play the same sound over itself, out of time from itself. Kind of like this. Flam it more. More. Yeah. Now pitch it down an octave. Okay, we had our clap. So far we had a good kick. We had a good clap.
and we had a good hi-hat. Once we had those three drums, we went about trying to find a groove. And we started with this reggaeton kind of thing. But that didn't really sound like H.A.R. So we tried this doo-wop thing. And we had done that before. So we ended up with this halftime trap sort of beat. Like this. Yeah, good start, okay. Then we wanted to find a piano line. And we wanted something that felt very emotional. A piano line like this. Then we added some bass, like this. Skeleton of the beat. But after working, we kind of got bored again, which seems to be a common theme in our work. So we went to the library. We were at the library in our college, and I remember I was working, and Jack was watching old home movies on his phone for some reason.
Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Put your heads closer together, please.
And I remember I looked from my work to Jack on his phone, and I just got so annoyed that I blurted out, "Would you put your phone down?" And Jack looked at me and said, "Say that again." So I said, "Would you put your phone down?" Then we called up Arnetta, and we said, "Could you play that on the trumpet?" Okay, we had our trumpet melody. The beat was sounding pretty good. But we still wanted it to be more emotional. So we added this violin line. Then we went about filling the drums out a little bit with these hi-hats and tambourines. Step. We had a really solid track, but what we needed was a really good melody to go on top of that track. And as Jack often does, he sent me this voice memo. But that wasn't catchy at all. So he sent me this one. But that was less catchy than the first one. We were really stuck. We really needed a melody here. And then we remembered those old home movies Jack was watching on his phone in the library. And do you remember at the start of this story, I told you it took 20 years to create this song? Here's why.
Don't you love it? No, I ain't happy yet.
sleep and I'm losing my mind. Cause it's half past three, my brain's on fire. I've been counting sheep, but the sheep all die. And I'm trying too hard, but I cannot try. Well, I can't fall asleep and I'm losing my mind.
Days
Can we get safety lights on right now, please? What the fuck? I think a light fell. Are you guys okay? There's glass on the stage right now. Can we get somebody on stage, please? This is not part of the show. Sorry, guys. This is not part of the show. They're sending people on to clean it up right now. Sorry, guys. We'll be back.
Thank you.
is what I should have said. I should be in bed, but of travel on my tongue, travel's yet to come. Life,
one sip,
bad for me.
One hit,
bad for me.
One kiss,
bad for me. But I give it so easily, and no thank you is how it should have gone. I should stay strong. They call me after dark, I don't want no fights. And my habits, they hold me like a grudge. I promise I won't bite. Life, bad for me. Bad for me. Bad for me. And I give it so easily. No thank you is how it should have gone. I should stay strong.
Oh,
For any of you who have seen us before, you know we always like to do a big, crazy finale. But I'd like to say something first, if that's all right. For the 18 years that we've been a band, one thing has been constant. There's always been some people who absolutely fucking hate us. Yeah, no, it's true. I remember back in high school, some of the kids made a club. It was like an anti-AJR club, and they would meet at lunch, and they would just talk about how bad the music was. And I don't know, maybe it was like the Broadway sound we had. I really don't know. But at the end of the day, made us feel really small. Fast forward about 10 years, the band started to do a little better. We had meetings with record labels, and all of them said the same thing. They all said, we're gonna put you in a room with writers. We're gonna change everything about you. Even today, it's hard to escape. You know, it feels like everyone on the internet has some kind of opinion about the things that we do on stage or the weird topics we're writing songs about. But every step of the way, there's been one thing that's kept us from listening to those people. And that was our dad. Even up until last year, it was our dad who told us to keep going, and one day you will find some people who see the world the same way you do. He was right, and now he's gone. In an instant, he's just not here anymore. And my dad had his flaws, but one thing I could say about him, he was really, truly, unapologetically himself. Every inappropriate joke he made at a dinner party, every time he embarrassed us by wearing AJR merch to a parent-teacher conference, he was being truly himself. And on his last day alive, we were in the hospital, we were joking around, saying goodbye. We asked him what his biggest piece of life advice was. He said, "Don't ever spend one second of your life not being yourself. Go be the biggest version of yourself." And it's a scary thing to do, but I'm gonna say something right now that I've wanted to say for a very, very, very long time. Fuck those high school bullies. Fuck those record labels. Fuck the internet critics that don't get what we're doing up here. For the rest of our life, we're gonna stand on this stage, walking on treadmills, bringing shadows to life, singing our weird songs. Because Grand Rapids, after 18 years, we finally found a room full of people that see the world the same way we do. Because life is really, really short, guys. It's way too short to not be the biggest version of yourself.
I wish I was me, whoever that is. I could just be, and not give a shit.